当作上重要。起码我想咧关心一下闽南，关心伊怎啊有沙吼，有好就对啦，会晓搬入，系啊，去无市场让我搬，嗯，啊无市场，现在无市场，都是无培养观众，对，观众啊，阮不看到咱这传统的物件，咱这布的是真好物件，全世界还阁无人对咱会丢啦，啊怎么叫人拍算就这款物件叫点落去？不但干那呢，连后场嘛拢要无去啊！看海无数长明琴，你个三江怀转念。
In the hands of Master Chen, the puppets appear at times delicate and tender, at times feisty and spirited. Lucy, an apprentice of Master Chen from France, continues to be impressed by his patience in teaching and dexterity of skill.
We don't speak always the same language, but it's very visual. So for example, if I make a mistake with my hand, he just shows me with his hand or changes on my puppet so I can understand easily.
Puppetry is an art form without boundaries. On stage, Master Chen controls legions of characters with his two hands. Off stage, he has devoted six decades to puppetry with little thought to wealth or fame. For Master Chen Shihuang, Taiwanese puppetry is his life. 1987 was a critical year for the Republic of China. During that year, the government lifted martial law and allowed citizens to visit relatives in mainland China. The following year, President Jiang Jingguo passed away, and his presidency was succeeded by Li Denghui. That was also the year the government lifted restrictions on freedom of speech and the press. Taiwan then entered a new era and saw a dramatic growth in social movements. Following the collapse of the Soviet Union and the end of the Cold War, the ROC government no longer regarded mainland China as a rebel group and lifted martial law on the outlying Jinmen and Manzhou Islands. The two sides of the Taiwan Strait moved past the confrontational tension of the Civil War period and began seeking peaceful dialogue. In 1993, the first round of cross-strait talks was held in Singapore, providing hope for a peaceful future across the Taiwan Strait. In 1996, Taiwan held its first direct presidential election. Prior to the election, tensions mounted on both sides of the strait, but for the first time in 400 years of Taiwanese history and 5,000 years of Chinese culture, the people were finally free to elect their own leader. A new democratic era had arrived as the people chose Li Denghui and Lian Zhan to be president and vice president of the Republic of China. In 2000, Democratic Progressive Party candidates Chen Shui-bian and Liu Shou-lian were elected as president and vice president. Taiwan witnessed its first transition of political power between parties. In 2008, the Kuomintang resumed power once again as the ROC ushered in a new era of party politics. From the two Zheng presidencies of the martial law period to democratically elected presidents in the era of peaceful transitions of power, the Republic of China now has a whole new look. From the first direct local elections in Hualien and Taidong in 1950 to the two major transitions of power in the 21st century, Taiwan has learned the true meaning of democracy, even in the midst of conflict and resolution. This democratic process has also taught the Taiwanese people how to work with those of differing political views. Wu Xuanshan believes that Taiwan needs a kind of coil or spring to allow room for mutual respect when communicating with people of other backgrounds.
只有一句话就可以解决所有台湾的问题啊！一句话是什么？我们民主的初步里面讲哈，少数服从多数啊。那么这个是大家是台湾的人没有掌握到的这么一句话。什么叫少数？今天我不喜欢陈水扁，我不喜欢马英九，但是大多数人选他，我就要服从大多数的人。我不能说因为我没有选他，我就不要他；我没有选给李登辉，我就不要李登辉。不是这个，因为人家一选上啊，就是大多数人选上李登辉，我们就要怎么样服从大多数的人，不是服从李登辉，就是所谓民主这最重要的观念。
From martial law to democratic rule, Father Jerry Martinson believes Taiwan has now become a very free and very democratic place. Still, people should learn to have more respect for different beliefs and views.
好朋友，有的是蓝的，有的是绿的啊。 不喜欢看他们太激烈的吵架或是不讲话啊。我觉得这个可能还是台湾人还是要学习尊重接受对方，保持自己的想法啊，没有问题啊，不过要用一种比较和谐的方式来讨论事情啊，讨论政治的事情，而且决定政治的方向啊。
With a 55-year-old grand auntie doll in one hand and a 50-year-old toy robot in the other, comic artist Liu Xingqing thinks Taiwan is actually enjoying too much freedom, even to the point of becoming disorderly.
真的，老百姓是逃街，现在的当官的人很可怜，我这个不投票给你啊，我们还可以抗议，但是不要过头。我现在总是认为哈，我们民主啊，台湾的民主过头。为什么没有次序了，变成乱用民主了啊？所以我在美国过生活，他到你府有一个我对面有一个大老板，他的员工来抗议哦，就是要申请哈，几点钟到几点钟，范围多大？他只是举着牌子在那个他门前要签字，他还不敢在他墙壁上贴一张说抗议的那个海报呢，他不敢抗议，说抗议就贴在，他没有心申请这一项。
Taiwan's political miracle and peaceful revolution have made it the envy of the world. It has also set a successful example for Chinese-speaking communities worldwide. But Liu believes the availability and quality of education in Taiwan still leaves something to be desired.
知识是提升了哈，但是哈，我很痛心的这个道德没有提升。公民道德这个没有提升。
Leo describes the Geelong River like this. In my youth, I could catch fish from the river and cook it on my boat. In my middle age, I could harvest clams and sell them for money. But in my old age, the river has become so polluted that I can hardly find sludge worms anymore. These are the consequences and the price of economic development. After six decades, Taiwan still has much to learn and many things to improve upon.One of the keys for sustaining Taiwan's development is striking a healthy balance between economic expansion and environmental protection. The 921 earthquake of 1999 taught Taiwan an important lesson in respecting the land and living harmoniously with nature. But the disaster also brought out the resilient and enduring character of the Taiwanese people.
I think Taiwan has gone through a lot of significant economic波动哈，还有许多世界这个经济的这个潮流的这个震动，但是台湾的韧性非常的强。
Since the relocation of the ROC government, Taiwan has evolved from authoritarian rule, disorder, and poverty to wealth, prosperity, freedom, and democracy. This bittersweet journey has been marked by successes as well as failures.
民间的这股文化无形的力量，这股软实力，将是扮演台湾。最终成功的地方。
台湾经过很多挑战，有那么多各方面的挑战，经济方面的挑战，大自然的一些挑战，政治方面的挑战，能够维持到现在，能够给他的老百姓很好的教育，很好的社会福利，这个我觉得是一个希望的一个很大的一个缘故。
The 21st century belongs to the Chinese-speaking world.As cross-strait relations continue to improve, Taiwan hopes to bring the influences of its political and economic miracles to inspire a peaceful transformation on mainland China. Taiwan has already become Asia's economic operations center and a beacon of democracy. In a changing world, the Republic of China on Taiwan will take on the role of integrator of the knowledge economy and once again generate another Taiwan miracle.